All right, all you Photoshoppers, Coach Kilburn here again with our second review video about Adobe Photoshop. This should help you leading up to your certification exam. Okay, so guys, here's a few things. Sampling colors. The eyedropper here samples colors. So again, if I'm on my eyedropper, I go on any color, I've sampled that color. Okay, if I want to sample a color off the background, use the eyedropper, there's the color. Okay, they may want you to add a color to the text that's exactly the same as something else in the image. They'll tell you what that is, right? Best thing to do is get your text tool, right? Highlight your text, go to the font color, the type color. When your cursor is in the color picker, you see you can pick a color. But when you move outside of the color picker, watch it change to the eyedropper. Then I can sample a color. Right? There's my new color. Now my text is the same color. Right? Again, get your text tool. Highlight your text. Go to the text color. Go outside of the color picker. Sample the color. And then you're good to go. Guys, always don't forget to apply the transformation by hitting the check or enter on the keyboard. Okay, so that's sampling color. All right, guys, file info. Don't forget about your file info. They're assuming you're working with a team, not just by yourself. And in the file info, you can place all kind of stuff. You can name the document. You can put the author's name, what their title is, right? You can put a description. Right, metadata and keywords, you can rate it. There's a copyright status. You can change the copyright status to copyrighted or public domain or unknown, right? You can add all this stuff in here, right? Just go to file info and add it in. All right, next thing, guys, you may have an image, right? Something like this, and part of the image is missing. They want you to use a tool that will make this part of the image look exactly like this part of the image. How do we do that? Content aware fill. So we get our selection tool, right? We select the area we want to fill, but we also got to go down here a little bit and give it some content, right? Photoshop makes a guess on what pixel colors to use to fill in that empty area. So if you do this, it's got no content. It only has white pixels. So you got to come down into the image a little bit. Give it a little bit of content to use. Now when I go edit, fill, move this box over here to this monitor, right? There's a lot of options you can use. Black, white, gray, pattern. Here we're using content aware. Right? Photoshop's making its best guess on what colored pixels to use. It's going to use those blue ones. Didn't look great, guys, but that's how you do it. Okay, we'll try to do it again. Highlight it. Come down here and give it some content. Right. Edit. Fill. Content aware. Right. It's going to make its best guess on what color to fill in there. So it should be filling in some blue. Again, guys, it didn't work great, but that's how you do it on the test. All right, next item, creating new documents, right? Guys, if they tell you to create a new document preset, right? Look right here, preset detail. So don't get thrown off by the word preset, right? Just remember that print has a category. That's RGB color, right? Anything on screen like film and video, right? TV, right? Oh, I messed up, guys. I messed up. Print should be CMYK, all right? So remember, CMYK is for everything printed. If we go to anything on screen like film and video, mobile devices, maybe the web, that all uses RGB. So guys, they'll tell you what to name it. They'll tell you the sizes and orientation. They'll tell you the resolution, right? You just need to come in here and be familiar with this area and do what they want you to do, okay? All right, next thing, guys, an iterative sketch. You may get a question about an iterative sketch, right? When we're designers, what we're supposed to do after we meet with our clients is give them a little sketch. And maybe as we work with the client through the design process, the sketch slightly changes. And we're going to present this iterative sketch to the client to make sure they like our ideas and they like what we're doing. They don't like it, we go back to the drawing board and we provide a different sketch. But an iterative sketch is a sketch in the design process that you supply to your client so they know what's going on and you're on the same page with your client. All right. Guys, they may want you to copy a layer style from one layer and paste it to another. Easy, right? I got some text here. It's got some layer styles. Guys, here's our layer styles here. I have a bevel emboss and a drop shadow. This layer of text does not. It's just plain. So I can come to this layer. I can right click, right? Look for copy layer style. Right here, copy layer style. Right, there's all kind of stuff you can do, but I want to copy the layer style, and then I'm going to come to this layer, and I'm going to right click, and I'm going to look for paste layer style. All right, you may have to scroll a little bit. Where are you at? Where are you at? Where are you at? Paste layer style. There it is right there, paste layer style. Boom. So now you see this layer also has the same layer styles. All I did was copy and paste. Very easy, guys. Okay, moving on. Guys, you need to know your file formats, right? When you save a document, you have the options of the different file formats to save as. There are many, many, many. You just need to know the basic ones. A PSD, that's the native file format for Photoshop. It supports all functions in Photoshop. You can do anything on this document in Photoshop because it's a PSD. Okay? Guys, other types. Bitmap, a BMP, a bitmap. Guys, a bitmap and a raster image, they're the same thing. What's a raster image? A raster image is an image made of pixels, those little squares. So raster file and bitmap file, they're kind of synonymous. They mean the same thing. Okay? Guys, GIFs are mostly for the web. They support animations. JPEGs are the most common file format. They're compression files, meaning when you save a PSD as a JPEG, it's going to squash all those layers into a background. It's going to get rid of some pixels. What does that do? It compresses it and lowers the file size for us, but we do lose a little quality. Okay, guys, pings. Pings are great files for the web. They're used in Microsoft Office products. They support transparency. They're also compression files, but they are lossless, meaning when you save a PSD as a PNG, you don't lose any quality, right? It does compress the file a little bit. The file size gets a little smaller. You don't lose any transparency, right? And there's a ping 8 and I think a ping 16. Which one do you think supports more transparency? Yes, ping 16, okay? And then guys, TIFFs. TIFFs are for photographs. TIFFs are for photographs, so there's your file formats. All right, guys, moving on. Raster versus vector. We use Photoshop right now. Photoshop creates raster images. Raster images are made out of pixels. So if my resolution is low, or I increase the size of a raster image, or I zoom in on it, I'm going to see all these little chunky edges. I'm going to see this pixelation, right? So with raster images, you don't want to increase the size, because it looks bad. Vector images do not work on little squares called pixels. They work on smooth lines and shapes based off mathematical formulas. So you can increase the size of a vector as large as you want, and it's not going to lose any of that quality. It's always going to look smooth like this, right? Adobe Illustrator creates vectors. Adobe Photoshop creates rasters. You do have some vector functions in Photoshop. All of your shapes and your type, right? They're all vectors when they first come out. We may have to rasterize those vector layers to do Photoshop functions to them, okay? How do you rasterize things, right? My rounded rectangle here, it's really a vector, right? It's really a vector, but if I right click, I can go to rasterize layer. Now that's not a vector layer, it's a pixel layer. Okay, difference between vector versus raster. All right guys, resampling. Resampling is a term you need to know. Let's say I have this image, doesn't look great. I wanna maybe bump the resolution up and make it look better. How do you resample? You go to image and image size, right? Bring this box over here. Guys, here's your resampling, right? So if I decide to add in more pixels, I got an image that doesn't look great. I wanna add in more pixels, right? I have resampling options. Since I made that bigger, right? I wanna go preserve details enlargement. If I made it smaller, I may wanna go bicubic sharper reduction. But since I added more pixels, I wanna preserve the details and pick enlargement. That added in more pixels and it attempted to make the image look better. Okay, so resampling is adding in more pixels. All right guys, don't forget you have the glyph panel. Remember, all panels we find under window. So if you don't see your panel, go to window, right? I have a glyphs panel. What does the glyphs panel have? It has all the things, or a lot of the things that aren't on the keyboard, right? So all these special characters from other languages, your trademark symbol, your copyright symbol, right? Your registered trademark symbol. It's got musical notes. Right? What does it have? It has musical notes, right? You can load up more glyphs here, right? So you got all these glyphs, right? They have musical notes in the glyphs panel. All right. That was a hint, people, if you're picking up on what I'm putting down. All right, guys. Print versus web, guys. Image modes. You'll get a lot of questions about print versus web. Guys, again, mode, anything on screen is RGB. Phones, laptops, projectors, smart boards, TVs, anything on screen is going to use RGB color mode. So if you get a question about preparing images for the web, it's RGB. Easy. Anything printed, magazines, books, T-shirts, posters, business cards, stickers, anything printed is CMYK. So any question you get about preparing images for print, it's got to be CMYK, guys. Easy, 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 easy. All right, guys, we're almost done here. Guys, blending modes. Don't forget you have blending modes. Blending modes blend down. They will tell you what layer to blend on what layer. Right, here's your blending modes. They'll tell you exactly which one to do, right? So you just need to know where the blending modes are, pick the one they tell you, all good and gravy. All right guys, content aware fill. Always make sure you're on the right layer. That's one way that people miss easy questions is they perform the function, but they're not on the right layer. So make sure you're on the right layer. How do we get rid of this person on the beach? Well, we need to select them. I like to use my lasso tool. Make sure you leave a little bit of content around the thing you're trying to fill. Again, Photoshop has to have a reference of what pixel colors to fill in. And then I'm going to go to Edit, Fill, and make sure it's on Content Aware. Right? Photoshop's going to fill that in. Boom, that's magic. It's magic. That person was there, now they're not. It's complete magic. Okay. Guys, I'm going to back up. All right. Don't forget there's a content aware move tool as well. All right. Where is that content aware move tool? There it is. Content aware move. In that case, I don't want to get rid of it. I just want to move it. So I select it. I drag it over here to where I want it. I got to apply the transformation by hitting the check or hitting enter. Photoshop's going to move it over for me. Boom. You can see a little bit here. But if somebody didn't know what I did, they'd never know that I just did content aware move. Guys, they may tell you to make a layer so it's non-destructive. They may tell you to edit a layer so you can edit it non-destructively. Guys, all that means is to right click and make it a smart object. Convert to a smart object. Smart objects are too smart to be destroyed, right? And then notice the look of the smart object. Here's a text layer. Here's a smart object. All right, here's an image layer or background. All right, I may want to add a mask. All right, here's your masks. This is the look of a mask. So looking at your layer thumbnails, this is a mask. This is a smart object. This is a text layer. Okay. All right, guys, and then you need to know all about your fonts, right? Font sizes, font colors, font styles. You can do a lot of that in the character panel, right? We talked about your leading and kerning and all that. You can change your color here, right? Make sure you're on your type tool. You also have fonts here, font sizes, alignments, colors. Don't forget your text warp here, right? All right, guys. I think that's enough. We're a little over 16 minutes. Make sure you watch this video. Should do fine on the test.